Once again, it's the Real to Real show.
Real to Real.
Yes, sir. I'm TD. Well, he's TD.
Right. TD's in the building.
And then,
what's going on, brother?
Yes, it's your red double D's. Yeah, I got this. This is, I got a good one. This is up our alley.
What's going on?
Okay, I was in the, I was checking out, they was talking about, an event that just passed. Just recently, anything? Just recently over there. And this happens to be the truth, like, across the nation, right? Where you have, you got a DJs, right? This whole DJ thing. Now, you have the local DJs. You know, we're hungry. You know what I'm saying? We try to get out there. We try to get our name and everything. So, we'll go hard when it comes to when we do a party or when we do a mix or whatever the case may be.
Okay.
You have the more famous established DJs who pretty much, in this climax DJ, that's pretty much secured their position, whatever, so they don't have to go as hard as the upcoming DJs. So what happens, that?
Go ahead. No. Well, see, first of all, the business is being saturated with DJs,
right,
with the technology and how easy you can get into the game, and you can actually create yourself a buzz via the internet and actually become a star, a well-known DJ without putting in the time. So I understand that point, but then I can't take it away from saying all the top cats ain't doing shit, because you always got your Jazzy Jeff, you got your DJ Scratches, you got your, you know, those are still cats with names that still get busy.
Well, see, I'm not talking about necessarily those that get busy. We all know Jazzy Jeff and the Kid Capri's. DJ Scratches, they tear it down every time. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
We're just talking about those, like you say, for instance, who might have, you know, in this day and time, you know, they on the internet, they working their Instagram, and they get out there, and,
So give me a name. You gotta be talking about something. Who would you say?
Well, I just...
Who's been running off fame for you? Name one person.
Well, I'm just saying, I don't want to hit them to holler. But we pretty much know there's a lot of them that have a fist-pumping pre-recorded sets. Okay? You have those who, you know, be slamming the damn song in the middle of the mix, offbeat.
Oh.
You know what I'm saying?
Famous? Somebody,
who,
no, you gotta put that out. Who would that be?
I'm saying I don't want to call him out because now that's the whole hater. Oh, man, you hate. Don't be hating on him. He's been a blah, blah, blah for years. But, here's another thing, too. Every DJ, like, every performance is not going to be stellar. That's just not reality.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? Everybody's going to have an off night. So you might have went... And you went up to an event and seen, it can even be like a Jazzy Jeff. You might have a witness, and Jazzy Jeff may have not given his most stellar performance. That doesn't make him garbage.
Oh, Bill Hood Jeff?
Right.
See, you gotta understand that Jeff and them played back in the day, man, when the needle still did jump, though.
Right.
Even though he was Jazzy Jeff, even back then, the cold in the motherfucker, all you DJ Scratches and anybody you can think of, Game Boss to Jazzy, to JMS to Jay, everybody. If he was on stage with Wax, that motherfucker skipped at one point in time out of the show.
Exactly.
Just part of the game.
Right. See, now the technology, even with the technology now, they've been situations where your laptop go out.
Yeah,
motherfucking, the shit don't load up, or the goddamn, the drive will get hot. So, you know.
Mm-hmm. There's always, but yeah, that part of the game. That's where the weak DJ won't survive. When you just DJing as a hobby, or when you really into DJing. That's when I first got into it, man. I'd do anything to do a party. Somebody said party. I said, yeah, I'll do it. And
right.
I made it happen. If I had the balls, the beaches, you know, enough.
Well, take your equipment. We've been through that, man.
made it happen, nigga. Motherfuckers been
right.
Been behind the couch. We gonna have this one over here, but this is gonna give us with the little muffler sound. We was making subwoofers before we even had subwoofers.
Right.
We just sticking the motherfucker speaker under the couch, nigga, put it in the corner.
Right.
And make the bass come deep.
I also gotta point this out that in today the bar has been lowered considerably in this day and time to when you was DJing 30 years ago. Because I remember where, you know what I'm saying, that needle skipped or you train wrecked that blend. You know what I'm saying? Or feedback off the turntable, motherfuckers just might start booing at you. You just might clear the motherfucker flow.
When I was younger, man.
You told me a story. You told me a story. You was in a DJ competition.
That after that situation there, it had been like, I'd say, damn it, 10 years before I even got lax enough to train
right.
To be totally honest, that's how much I play. I was like on some new shit. I woke up in the morning, first thing. First thing in the morning, I'm going downstairs before I was going to school, man.
Right.
I turn on music, and the motherfucker's like, man, come on, man, get dressed. And I jump up, I'm getting dressed, music playing. I do a mix before I leave. I'm mixing in my head, all in school.
Right.
I can't wait to finally get home, because when I do, I'm back on the set, I'm spending. So by the time I got to the party, when you say pre-programmed, I pretty much had a bunch of different sets. Wasn't so much pre-programmed, but I did always knew what to go with that.
Well, I'm saying, when I say pre-programmed, I'm talking about there'll be DJs who, they're playing their recorded set, and they're pretty much lip-syncing.
Uh-huh.
Well, you know how motherfuckers lip-sync the song? They're they're hand-syncing the fucking set. The set is only being played somewhere else, and they on their hand on the turntable like they doing something.
Oh, no kidding.
We've seen countless videos where a dude, or like it'll be a performance on TV or something, and dude had a DJ set, had the DJ set up, and the shit ain't even plugged in. You don't see the cords to the damn turntable, the mixer, or nothing. But he's just going.
Oh, Lord.
He's just jacking. He's up there. He's fist pumping. He's like, ah, ah, ah. And niggas is like, where is the plugs at? Where the plugs at?